Week four, we're back at it with the ice sale on Meg Kelly, joined today by junior forward Riley Childs of the women's basketball team. Riley, how are you doing today?
I'm pretty good, Meg. It's a little cold out, but not that bad. How are you?
Yeah, it's definitely a little chilly these days with the winter setting in. We're at pretty much the halfway point of the season, playing Holy Cross, Army, and Colgate for a second time now. What it will be like this time as opposed to the first meetings?
I think this time around, like you said, we've already played all the teams, especially playing two games in a row. It's already like the third time, which is totally new for us. But coach has really been talking about getting better as a team, like working on ourselves. And then we just have to really focus about us and just get better at what we're good at. And then it'll all kind of go from there. I mean, I'm excited to play these teams again. Hopefully have some better games in there mixed in, but it should be good. There's some good teams, so.
Yeah, it's definitely a competitive Patriot League. Every team is going to bring it every day, so you can't take any days off. And even though we've seen them, everybody's going to be different the second time around from the start of January. Now we're basically at the end of the month. What has the growth been like during these last 4 weeks of play?
I think for us, there's just been like a new level of dedication to what we're doing. Obviously, it's hard playing in the season as long as it is to begin with, and then you throw COVID in, and you have to be super careful about who you're seeing and everyone. It's the longest time for a lot of people that they've been from home, so just like the whole new added level of dedication there has just grown within this past 4 weeks. And it hasn't been easy, but we're still going, and I think it's just going to get stronger from here, and hopefully we can keep pushing and just keep working hard and making each other better every single day. I think that's something we've been really focusing on in practice too, is just making it as competitive as games are and making each other tougher and better and just trying to do the best we can, I guess.
Yeah, certainly everyone's just doing the best they can and during this time, and especially on the basketball court. And for you, you're a junior now and you're in your second season of being captain. You've been a main stalwart in the lineup for 3 years now. But what has your growth kind of been like, especially as a leader on the floor since you started?
I think this year for me, it's been a lot different as a captain than it was last year. Last year, it was more of a learning year in the position, I would say. I really leaned on Katie Nelson and Nia Irving and Vanessa a lot, and just like following them and their leadership skills. And mine was always like being the hype person on the floor and stuff like that. And that's obviously still my role now. But I think the older I'm getting and the younger the team's getting, the more important it is for me like to step up as a leader. And I think I've just taken on some more of the job, I think, than I had in last year. And obviously I still lean on Katie a lot, and we have Emily Esposito with us too. So the three of us really are working together really well this year. And we have like bi-weekly captains meetings where we just check in with each other and make sure everything's going well. And I just think for me, I'm trying to keep learning as I grow. I still have more to go, but it's been great.
Not only are you leadership on the floor, but on the floor, you're especially talented at rebounding. It seems every time there's a shot goes up, pretty good chance you're going to come down with it. What kind of goes through your mind when you're on the court, whether offensively or defensively rebounding? What are you looking for when those shots are in the air?
Defensively, I'm pretty undersized for my position, so I kind of have to be physical down low, getting the rebounds. And I've always loved rebounding since I was in high school and stuff. And I was like the biggest one in high school, so it was a lot easier for me then. But that's always been a huge part of my game. So I knew when I came in as a freshman, that was going to be a big contribution for me. And then on offense, a lot of times my dad always taught me that a shot is always a pass for you when you're offensive rebounding. So I just try to go in, and I know a lot of times when I get an offensive rebound or when someone else gets a rebound on my team, it's always a really big confidence boost for everybody. And it's like another wave of excitement for that possession. So I'm always just trying to get in there and help my teammates out as much as I can, because even if like I'm not the main scorer, which has never been an issue, like I know I can help my teammates out through rebounding. So I've just tried to focus on that, especially this season.
And for anyone who hasn't seen you play, you have an incredible passion for basketball. You fire everyone up throughout at any point in the game. That's one thing that's very noticeable in your personality. So where does that come from?
I think it comes from, like you said, I have a really big personality anyway. And I think when I first got here, it was one of the first times I had fully been surrounded by people who loved basketball as much as I did. And I've loved it since I was little. Like I said, my dad has been a huge part of my basketball journey and stuff. And he always was pushing me to be better. And I think it just made me love the game even more. And then as far as the team goes, like, I just love to get excited for other people. I mean, sometimes it's hard and you got to really push yourself, but I think because I have such a big personality off the court that on the court, it just comes out more. And like, I love getting excited when Mary gets an M1 or when Katie or Maggie makes a three. And it's just like, I try and build the energy for other people because I know it's what really helps the team when stuff isn't going our way, especially.
Yeah, your energy definitely fires me up to yeah, fire off those tweets even faster after that. But thank you so much for your time this morning, Riley. It was great chatting with you and looking forward to see you back in action this weekend.
Thank you for having me.